Lazy winter afternoons, starting out too late, giving up too soon. Coming home to coffee and a trashy book, never paying any mind. If things were never done on time, was when a fella could just let time slip away. No worries, car or telephone, just rent and food to pay. And every night with single buddies boozing at the bar, living for the minute, taking every hour in it. But now there's just too much to do in any given day. The car, the phone, the kitty shoes, too many bills to pay. Running from the crack of dawn till Baba weeds the news, and falling into bed too wiped to even kiss the wife goodnight. Just another working Joe.
Scare myself sometimes.
Whoa, the baby's in the swing-o-matic, singing rock and roll. My sweetie's in the kitchen, whipping up my favorite casserole. I knocked off work at 10 o'clock, the kids are still in school. The coffee pot is perking, to hell with bloody working. Whoa, it sure is sweet to sit at home and let time slip away. Though tomorrow I'll be scratching through another working day. But when I start to come apart from all the things to do, I know that I'll be taking soon another lazy winter afternoon. Just another working Joe. Last night here at McCabe's, we apparently just missed a whole bunch of Morris dancers. That was...
Wasn't for lack of trying.
Is there anybody here who doesn't know what a Morris dancer is? Hands up. Those of you who don't know what Morris dancer is.
Oh, you lucky few.
Oh, there's quite a few.
Believe me, in this case, ignorance truly is bliss.
Morris dancers, for those of you who don't know, are cute little people who whip around in little white suits, and they tie sleigh bells to their feet and strap long white hankies to their wrists, and they sort of prance around. And it's perfectly harmless behavior. Nothing wrong with it, really. The only really alarming thing is that from time to time, Morris dancers will arm themselves with a kind of a cudgel or bludgeon or club, some kind of blunt instrument like that, and they'll gather into a mystic circle, and to the accompaniment of accordion and violin. They will rhythmically and ritualistically hit each other with these clubs again and again and again. And this is considered to be a form of entertainment or British fertility ritual or something like that. In any case, Morris dancers, for the most part, are harmless. And they sometimes like to dance to this tune. It has the sort of knuckle-dragging Neanderthal beat that they like to dance to. If there are any Morris dancers here tonight, I warn you, if you jump up, there are propellers in the ceiling. Watch it.
And last Morris team we had tried to jump up and ran into the propellers on the ceiling. They were just cut to rat meat.
It was horrible. So just be careful, okay? I mean, it's like drinking and driving. You want to make it home to the kids, all right? I often take these night shift walks when the foreman's not around. I turn my back on the cooling stacks and make for open ground. Far out beyond the tank farm fence where the gas flare makes no sound. I forget the stink and I always think back to that eastern town. I remember back 6 years ago, this western life I chose. Every day some news would say some factory's going to close. Well, I could have stayed to take the dole, but I'm not one of those. I take nothing free, and that makes me an idiot, I suppose. So I bid farewell to the eastern town I never more will see. But work I must, so I eat this dust and breathe refinery. Oh, I miss the green in the woods and streams, and I don't like cowboy clothes. But I like being free, and that makes me an idiot, I suppose. This western life's no paradise, but it's better than lying down. Oh, the streets are clean and there's nothing green, and the hills are dirty brown. But the government dole will rob your soul back there in your hometown. So bid farewell to the eastern town you never more will see. There's self-respect and a steady check in this refinery. You will miss the green in the woods and streams, and the dust will fill your nose. But you'll be free and just like me, an idiot, I suppose. Singles bar scene ever really big here? I mean, it looked big in the movies.
What?
Well, I don't know. It's just coming to Canada.
Did you get all the John Travolta clones around here? Yes. We still have them up in Canada. Stan refers to them as, you know, these guys that all back comb their chest hair and stuff, you know.
Yeah, they got those little double knit leisure suits on, and they got their shirts open to the navel, and they got all that gold hanging down there, and the little nest they make out of their chest hair. And they got brilliantine in their hair, and they sort of walk around in that kind of hip shot walk, you know, when they walk in. And just if they put a bell on the end of it, he'd be making a hell of a noise.
Our father figured out why it is that John Travolta is so popular with certain species of the feminine persuasion. It's because when you're kissing John Travolta, you can close, or you can open one eye and look into both of his. I guess he's living proof that a little knowledge is a dangerous thing.
Well, for those of you who've ever infested a singles bar or feel tempted to try it, this one might prepare you for what you're about to find.
Steal half of a heart away.